I'm from the area that where you have very rich biodiversity. We try all the tools, all the means, try to protect this biodiversity. But then we have a lot of questions associated to it, also out of frustration. First, biodiversity seems to be a peripheral concept to the government, to the people. How to make biodiversity relevant to people? How to interpret that natural system actually does good to people is already challenging enough, but also that has contributed to the issue that the development went in its own way without really taking or integrating biodiversity into the whole picture. We all know that what biodiversity faces today, the destruction today, is all caused by human-introduced behavior activities. So ultimately, you're facing two camps. You know, the development, especially in China, you see the development going so fast that you don't even have time to react to those problems. Dams being built every day, lands being converted to cities every day, roads going into the used to be inaccessible areas that causing a lot of damage to the natural system, and population still growing in the large scale. And consumption, especially in China, consumption, not only population growing, but also the consumption is amplified by the growing demand for resources. Now China is not enough to provide those resources. We start to take resources from all over the world. So we observe that every day. So it's very striking how we could respond to this large-scale changes while continue doing protected areas protection or dealing with a couple of villages in the remote area. So we constantly have to balance what we do in villages, in remote areas where biodiversity are, and the large-scale changes in urban area at the global scale. And in the meantime, we question ourselves, when we do this work in the villages, in Western China, in the mountains, are we actually changing this overall actually have an influence to the overall changes? We don't always have it. So feeling the confusion of winning battles which we feel comfortable, which is expertise we have, the things we feel comfortable to do, in the same time losing the wall, which is the fact that species going extinct more in a more rapid speed, and habitats more fragmented because all this introduced development activities, which to tell the fact that many people support it, because people make money, people find jobs in those development processes. So if conservation is going to win, we have to raise the equivalent amount of value that benefits the human society as development does. Although in the same time, we see that the development becomes so destructive that it itself won't last for long. But the dilemma is, whether it's government or development agencies, they look at current. Government officials have turnover for every 3 to 5 years, 5 years the longest, 2-3 years people change. How could you ask them to take a longer term vision when they looking for job, people are looking for jobs and government officials are looking for the area, things that can rapidly show they are effective as government? So we are facing that battle. I don't have an overall answer, but the system I also see is changing toward that direction. For example, payment for ecosystem service is really an economic tool that makes conservation profitable to some people that actually take conservation seriously and really protect the ecosystem at their homeland that produce service to larger group downstream, water as a watershed, to provide water resources downstream, to protect the forest, which has carbon sequestration that reduces global warming. And so now a new set of market is being created, like carbon trade, like payment for watershed conservation. Things are happening, but these are not nearly at the scale that is able to slow down or combat the current development. So that made me think that it's not what's wrong with the development. It's not, things are not coordinated. As conservation part of the conservation community, I think we have not done a good job to really explain, or first, accumulate data and turn this data into knowledge, human knowledge that explains the relationship between the nature, the ecosystem, and development. Two, even the knowledge is there, it's not translated into something that policies, development policies, can appreciate or can use immediately. And three, we have not done work with education system, schools. So children from when they are little, they start to learn the relationship between the nature and the society, the societal development. So these are long-term jobs we need to do better. I think that's my overall take of things we have not done better. But in the same time, we need to work directly with the ones we used to see as enemies, businesses, governments, whose focus is to bring is the development agenda. If we explain well on why nature has to be part of the development agenda, then things could be better coordinated. So I think we often see that world is going wrong in the wrong way, but on the other hand, I also see that we have not done enough to make sure that the right message is delivered to the right people. So I hope that this the whole world can be involved as part of this overall discussion on what the sustainability is, to not to the world but to ourselves, to individuals. There is a need for societal change, as I just mentioned, government policy changes, business policy changes, but there is also need of average people to change, because people ultimately is a consumer of this world. What we want things happen, what we don't want things happen, what we want to buy, what we don't want to buy, will ultimately influence the industrial behavior, performance, and also influence the policies. And things are intertwined, you know, how to make environment, how to make biodiversity conservation a fashionable, something fashionable, so fashionable that everyone wants to take action. That's my vision. That's the ideal world. But we're not far from that yet. But I think if we have a vision, we have a motivation to move on.